Hey guys, Info Broad here, and today we're going to be looking at a new song that was just released 6 hours ago by Stray Kids. And I know, Stray Kids, I heard them before. Well, it is the very first video that I ever reviewed. So, with a new premiere, and they just only released it, why not go into it heads on? I've never heard the song yet, I've never seen the video yet, and I'm really curious how All In performs compared to Backdoor. And I can expect a lot from them. They really set a high bar with Backdoor, of course, more in the choreography rather than in the video, but I hope to see a similar energy. I hope to see a similar flow. So I'm really curious on what we're going to see. But before we jump into the video, if you have any videos that you would like me to review in the near future, then please make sure to place them in the comments and I'll make sure to look at them in the near future. And let's jump into Stray Kids with All In. Starting already with some fire, heating up the entire thing. I really love the way they are standing out completely from the rest. I really love how he's very white compared to the background yellow. Because what a lot of people fail at is that they tried to make this also look yellow, making him look like he's in the light, in the yellow. But here they did a great job of making sure that he still looks like he's wearing his white clothes with some blue pattern on there, which is really good done. Just making sure that the subject is in focus and not being blended into the background. It's very clean. Wait, that's super cool. I mean, I'm just noticing it now with the cloning technique. You can see that it's one group over here and another group over there, meaning here they did some masking, but it's really clean done. I really, first of all, didn't see it. I thought it was just all the members wearing the same type of clothes looking like clones, but now I can see it. They are the same people and they did it very cleverly and it just looks edited beautifully. They did not do this in Stray Kids with Backdoor, but here they just made sure it looks good. It looks really matching. And they did a very good job here. Very clean. They really love showing off the energy here. I mean, they look like they're having some good fun here, which is always nice to see in a video. And that's the same as Backdoor. Having fun and showing fun is always more important than the entire video because you can just see the energy that they're trying to portray here. And it's always more fun and enjoyable to watch rather than someone being forced to do a certain part. And everyone looks genuine here, so. That was kind of cool with the go down and then the camera also swings down. That's very cool. Let's check out the choreography. That is a really cool effect. Really on beat and very clean. Toot toot. Super. Whoa, did that just move? Oh no, it just went going down. Okay, that's okay. But what I can already say here is that the editing here is a little bit more simplified than Backdoor. But for that, everything looks so much more cleaner than what it was with Backdoor. Like, more simple effects, but it just makes the video look so much better compared to adding these difficult transitions that don't really make a good impression if they're not done well. And so far, this looks so much better than Backdoor in the video production world. Stand up and show your skills. You know the drill. Yeah. Psycho my dad, just keep it true. That's how we super cool transition. On the beat, new scene, fantastic. Sometimes you feel like giving up. I don't know if this is something I'm just paying attention to now, but I noticed that their feet are always cut off. And if there's one thing that I learned with K-pop especially, I kind of like the way they move their feet, and I don't understand why it's always cut off, because even when they dance here, for example, again, it's always waist up. Maybe that's the highlight of the dance. Or here, waist up. Waist up. Okay, that's nothing. Here, we get some feet, but it's still cut off. And I think this move, this shot would be really cool if they just had their feet all in focus, aka a very straight shot. But then you can see how their feet move from left to right really quick. I think that would have added a little bit more to this particular scene. But for the rest, the choreography is spot on once again. I love lens flares. They are always so cool to look at. And here it just adds a little bit of extra James Bond kind of style. And it's cool. Very clean cuts. And I love this little break. Like I told you at the very beginning of my series, that when you have a chance to just make sure that the people are relaxing in their heads, this is one of those scenes where you're like, okay, they're not dancing, taking some air, relax a little bit, and then it goes back into power, as I think they're gonna do now again. You see? Into power. Boom. Super cool. There we go. Those are the shots that I really like. Everyone just having fun. Like literally, it's just cool that they have this one little element, this one little subject calming down the entire scene, and then it just goes back into energy. I really like that they added this. It's something different that they didn't do in Backdoor. I don't know if they did it in any of their other music videos, but that they added it here is really nice because the song is really quick and it's a lot to take in. So it's a nice little break, a nice little relaxation to the brain. I also like this very simple screen effect a lot. It's something simple, but it adds something cool. It all tells a little bit of a story between all the characters, all the Stray Kids members, and it's something simple, but it just is so cool. Very quick pause here. I just noticed that from everyone that's looking at the camera, you have one guy here not looking at the camera. And of course I can understand it, and I'm not going to give them points taken away here, but I really think that backdrop that's on fire, they only had one take to do this right, and they didn't have another prop to put on fire. Though it's a small thing, it is something that I wish that he did look at the camera, because if this was a picture, like a family picture, everyone looks at the camera except for one person, you'll try to reshoot it. But I think, like I said, they only had one take, but next time, please just look at the camera. It's a small detail, but it adds just a little bit more of a perfect picture at the end, especially when it's the end shot with the entire group. So guys, that was Stray Kids with All In. And let me tell you this from the bat on, you know, it was a really good video. I think they really improved the quality of their video and they made a much better production out of this. It's full of energy, full of flow, and it follows the people, the dancers, the choreography, Stray Kids, much better and much cleaner. And the edits are more simplified, but they're just a little bit more effective. Like I say, nothing has to be super complex. And of course, here they're still trying to show that they're able to edit from different scenes, different dance patterns really quickly into each other. It's fine. Of course, I talked about a few negative things, and that's totally fine. You have these small things such as, you know, not looking at the camera. You have small things like them not really focusing on their feet. These things can be improved easily on the next video, and I'm not really going to give harsh points taken away for this. The only thing that I think is missing is the actual emotion from the videographers. It is there, but it's just all too flat, meaning all the shots are from the front, and I wish that they did a little bit more like Taemin, or use Taemin with Criminal as a example. It's the only thing that I can say, look at the emotions with all the flow, look at all the movements, the way the cameras follow each movement. It's so much cleaner and it's just so much more effective. And here they're so close to perfectionizing their own videos, but they are still a few steps away, and I hope in the near future they can achieve it, because with these good signs, they are really making sure that they're doing their best. So to give it a point, I am going to give it a clear 8 out of 10 because there is still room for improvement. If it was me, I would have redone a few shots. I would have made sure that the camera angles are a little bit more flexible, a little bit more emotional, a little bit more engaging with the dancers, and not that everything is done in post. Not that all the pans, all the movements are done in post because you shot in 6K rather than 4K, giving you the room to edit, of course. But you kind of notice that it's a bit automated. It's not as clean as it could be if everything was shot directly with the hand. Thank you very much for watching. So yeah, guys, thank you very much for watching. And if you did enjoy this video, hit the like button and make sure you subscribe for the next review. And again, if you have any videos that you would like me to review in the near future, then please leave them in the comments below and I'll make sure to look at them in the near future. Thank you very much and see you next time.